Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today I really wanted to work out of this book. I got this book as a Christmas present, and so I've been really loving Molly Harrison. I mean, I've loved her work for a few years, but I never really colored in any of her coloring books. So today I thought it would be nice to see if I can find the page. Yeah. Okay, so here is the page I was looking for. I should have marked it. This is the page that I thought we would work on today. And with her, with Molly Harrison pieces or illustrations, I really like to go with real moody colors, dark, and browns. And so today I thought for this one we would use some kind of browns and grays for this brick or stone wall. We're going to make it more of a stone wall, and some purples, and then in the background some grays and purples. And for the stone wall here, I was thinking of basing it with distress inks and then coloring over the top. So I think we'll do that for the base for this. And then the background, I'm really loving my gelatos right now. So we're gonna do a background in gelatos. And I will list all of the colors and supplies as usual down below. All right, so let's go ahead and get started on this. Okay, so before I got too far going on this, I decided I needed to put down some low-tack washi tape just so I could kind of contain the mess there with those distress inks and not get it onto the other page and off outside of the border of the image. Also, I sped up this portion of the video in the interest of keeping the video to a manageable time, but you can easily see what I'm doing here. Just going back and forth between those two colors, just kind of give it more of an aged, you know, stone look. And then we'll go back in with the pencils and give it some more shading and depth. But that won't be till a little later on after we color the fairy. And also, I'm not too concerned about going over her hair because her hair is going to be a blackish gray color anyway.
All right, so here I am basing the Fairies skin, hair, and dress with my Ohuhu markers. And I have listed the colors below and on the screen for you. Now, if you don't have those same exact colors, whatever you have that is similar would work just fine. Okay, so starting with the pencil work here, I'm taking my white And I just want to make sure I get those highlight areas in. They're on along the edge of her face and down her arms, and just filling in those highlight areas so that I can make sure that they don't get too dark. And I'm going to do that with her hair as well. So I'm just starting the blend with that 10% warm gray, and then I'll finish the blend with my Prisma Colorless Blender. And so I just continue in that manner all the way down the rest of her hair. here I've pulled out my Schpirerr Farben Black. I really like this pencil. It's a has a nice fine hard point on it. You don't necessarily have to use this brand. If you have like a polychromo black or whatever black that you happen to have that has a harder lead on it than the Prisma black. But if you don't, the Prisma black is fine. Just make sure you have it nice and sharpened. And I will be using this Schpirerr Farben black a little bit more throughout this video. And here I'm using my silver Posca. And you don't have to use a silver Posca. If you have a silver gel pen, that would work just fine. But I really like the silver Posca because I'm going to go back once it dries, and with that black Schpirerr Farben pencil, I'm gonna add a little bit of shading to it. So it produces kind of a nice aged metallic look. So as I was coloring her wings, I noticed kind of a weird line that didn't seem to go with her wings or the moon in any way. So I went ahead and whited that out with my white Posca. So like I did with her hair and the 10% warm gray and the colorless blender, I will do with her wings using the white to start the blend and then going back in with the colorless blender to kind of complete the blend. Additionally, with the white, I am trying not to go all the way to the edge of the wing as I want to keep the edges really dark. So I want the light to be towards the middle of those sections, if that makes sense. And then when we go in with that colorless blender, we'll blend all of it. So I'm going back in with my Schpirerr Farben Black and really darkening up the outer edges of those wings. And it just really creates a nice effect. Okay, so I'm going to end this video for today, and then we'll come back for part two and finish the page. Thank you so much. I hope you've enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time.